Greetings, party members. If you were hoping to read The Theory and Practice of Oligarchical Collectivism by Emmanuel Goldstein,
you're in the wrong spot. Because this is the simplified guide to the inner party for new members. Welcome to the inner party. We hope you're enjoying your new black overalls and roomy apartment. We know you support Oceana's war efforts, and maybe you hope that with your leadership, Oceana can finally defeat its enemies for once and for all. Great! There's just a little problem. We don't actually want this war to end. Why? Well, as you know, the world is divided into three superstates: Oceania, which includes the areas formerly known as the Americas, Britain, Australasia, and the southern part of Africa; Eurasia, which includes northern Europe and Asia; and East Asia, which includes the region formerly known as China and surrounding countries. These superstates have been at war for 25 years. When Oceania is allied with East Asia, it's at war with Eurasia. And when Oceania is allied with Eurasia, it's at war with East Asia. But what am I saying? Oceania is at war with East Asia, and Oceania has always been at war with East Asia. We always fight over the same area, the part around the equator where one-fifth of the world's population lives. And Antarctica. We fight over that too. Everyone wants those penguins. But mostly, we want the cheap labor we can get from enslaving the people in the equatorial regions. With more cheap labor, we can make more war! Now maybe you're thinking that a well-planned attack could take the enemy's heartlands. Well, we could attack their heartlands. But just imagine what trouble we'd have if we won. We'd either have to exterminate everyone, which would take so many resources, or we'd run the risk of having our citizens mingle with their citizens, and then they might learn that the enemy is really a lot like themselves, and they'd be less enthusiastic about making war. Then we need to keep making war. I mean, we don't need to exactly. We're big enough that we can produce the goods we need. And it's not like the other superstates have some weird belief systems we want to destroy. We all believe roughly the same things. Plus, it's not likely we'll ever win. After all, both of the other superstates are awfully powerful, and none of us really has an advantage over the other. But what's that you say? Don't we have a stockpile of atomic weapons? Well, we do, but we're not going to use them. Back when nations were dropping atomic bombs on each other, it got to the point where society could have completely broken down. And if society completely broke down, then the party wouldn't be able to rule. So we don't drop bombs. But don't worry, Eurasia and East Asia don't either. No one's out to annihilate anyone. We just want to make war. You're still not sure why? Well, let me explain. In the past, people imagined that science and technology would continue to progress and raise their standard of living. And there's no question that science and technology were making things better. People in the past lived better than they do now. Unfortunately, science and the party don't really get along. Science requires you to be logical and to test ideas to make sure that your hypotheses match with reality, not just with what you want to believe. And goodness knows, we don't want people to be logical or think for themselves, or to be remotely concerned with reality. The only uses the party has for science are to improve our spying techniques so that we can know what people are thinking, and to make better weapons for war! Now, if we could just figure out how to kill several hundred million people in a few seconds without giving an advance warning, that would really be something. What we don't want is for technology to raise the standard of living. If people aren't kept really busy just trying to feed and clothe themselves, they might start to think for themselves. They might even start to question the need for the party to tell them what to do. We can't have that. Plus, if no one has much of anything, then having something like great carpet or nice cigarettes means you're pretty special. You're enjoying your new apartment, right? Anyhow, keep them poor and ignorant, as Big Brother says.
Yay!
Or rather, as Big Brother would say if he were real. Long live Big Brother! War is a great way to keep people poor. We don't have to stop producing goods, which would make people upset. We can just use all of our surplus production for the war effort. Think about it. We invest thousands of man-hours and materials into building a floating fortress. Then in a few years, we say the fortress is obsolete, scrap it, and build a new one. Everyone is kept busy and nothing at all is produced that would make life better for anyone. With war, you just blow up or sink any excess stuff, and no one can complain. But don't think that keeping people in a state of poverty is the only reason for the war. War just kind of creates the right mood in the nation. Think about it. If people are afraid they'll be blitzed by a dangerous enemy, they're more likely to hand all of the power over to a group of strong leaders. And that's us. We need brokers who are competent enough to get their jobs done, but who are also willing to swallow our lies and to feel the emotions that make people irrational. You know the ones. Anger, fear, hatred, worship, triumph. So what's your duty as a good member of the inner party? The important thing to remember is that we don't really want to win this war. Because the real war is with our subjects, and the real point of the war is to keep society intact, with us at the top. Don't worry, the leaders of East Asia and Eurasia think just the way we do, and as long as we all do our parts, the three superstates will function like the three legs of a stool that keep the thing from toppling. As long as we agree to permanent war, it's pretty much the same as permanent peace, only, you know, better. Of course, as an inter-party member, you'll also be expected to hate the enemy more than anyone else. You've got to be completely dedicated to world conquest. Oceania must rule the world. If we could just develop the right weapon. Wait, you're saying that those two ideas contradict each other? How can we want to make the war last forever and want to win the war? Well, comrade, you wouldn't have gotten this far in the party if you weren't great at doublethink. Good luck, and enjoy those new overalls.